8:12 here on Breakfast Television. Time for a little entertainment, but not the nicest entertainment we're going to start with, though.
No, not the nicest
entertainment.
It's been a while since we've had a Weinstein update, so we do have some news on the Weinstein front. It seems they're close to a deal in the class action lawsuits. There have been 15 lawsuits filed against Harvey Weinstein and the Weinstein Company of misconduct, and it's looking like the amount wasn't revealed in court, but the Wall Street Journal reports the civil settlement is worth $44 million.
To be spread out amongst those people.
He's got a lot of court dates ahead of him. Of course, he also faces criminal charges of
rape. Yeah, and those don't go away because of this.
No, they are separate entities completely. So he faces the charges of rape and performing a forcible sex act, and that trial is scheduled to begin in September. So, he does deny all acts of non-consensual sex. So this is going to,
let's get this.
The Twitterverse. Want to play with the beehive.
I'm going to be Dion's friend on this one.
Are you?
Yes,
okay.
Go ahead, explain.
Roger and I have been debating this when we were in break. So Dionne Warwick, of course, a legend and who's done amazing, amazing things in music.
I was blown away how many top 100 she had, like 60 or something like that?
Yeah.
Crazy numbers.
Yeah, and her name might not be a household name to some younger people, but for a lot of people, Dionne Warwick was a legend of a certain time. And she gave an interview to Essence magazine. She's 78 years old, and she questioned whether Beyoncé will reach the level that classic musicians from the 60s have. She said, quote, she doubts Queen Bee can sustain her career and become a big icon like Gladys Knight, Patti LaBelle, Frank Sinatra, or Sammy Davis Jr. did. And Warwick did say that she loves Beyoncé to death and she can appreciate her talent, but that iconic status, it's a long road. I would say this.
Ready? Go ahead.
I would say that Beyoncé has been on that road a long time. I mean, Destiny's Child split up in 2006. Beyoncé has been making records on her own for 13 years.
And she's most nominated female artist, right, for Grammys?
Yeah, for the Grammy Awards.
So 24 nominations.
I think, like, she's ticking a lot of icon boxes already.
Absolutely. But her last line, what did she say? She said, she's not throwing shade, but she's looking at it with reality. She's not sure if people will be singing the songs or will be actually able to sing the songs of today. Which I understand what she's arguing with that. Like, a lot of Motown songs, you can burst into them. You can sing along with them, and they stay with you.
I'll tell you this.
Some of the ones today, when they use the auto...
I can't sing a Dionne Warwick song, but I can bust out a single ladies anytime.
The good times, the bad times.
Old single ladies,
I'll be
single
on
ladies.
Your side
oh, no. Come on. You're with me, right?
That's what friends are for. Okay, who's right?
Beyoncé, icon status already. Never mind not getting there. I think she already is there.
At BT Toronto, let us know who you like.
Yeah. Coming up.
Yes.
It's a brand new Jasmine and a brand new Aladdin, and I've got an interview with the star Naomi Scott.
Beautiful.
Yeah.
Beautiful film.
Yeah, it really is.
All right, let's head upstairs now to Mel.